Hello children, in this session we shall see the basics of report writing. We will first understand what is report writing, look into the format of report writing and an example of a report. Now let's see what is a report. A report is a clear and concise document. It is a factual as well as objective account of an event or an incident. It aims at giving an accurate presentation without any personal opinions or views. So, in other words, the purpose of the report is to give clear and complete information. It is a first-hand description of an incident or event for a particular audience. A report may be written for a school magazine, a journal, or a newspaper. Now, children, in order to write a good report, we must bear the following things in mind. A report must be brief, to the point, and systematic. That is, always report the event in order in which the things have happened. It must be given heading or a title, the name of the person writing it and date. It must be written in past tense. It must contain details of the incident like what, how, why and when it happened, any special happening, action or mishap, etc. The concluding remarks or action taken or action that has happened are required. Some points to remember while writing a report. A catchy heading, that is a heading should be short and concise. Name of the reporter, it can be a staff, correspondent or any reporter. Place and date, it should be clear, example Hyderabad, September 29th. Use impersonal language. Avoid the use of I, we, us, my, etc. Now let us see the features of a report in detail. A report must have a headline, a byline, a lead paragraph, the second paragraph, and a conclusion. What is a headline? Every news article has a headline to attract the attention of the reader. The headline must state the topic of the news in a strong, short phrase or statement. It must be catchy. It must be brief. All articles, prepositions, etc. must be left out. Abbreviations and shortened word forms can be used. What is a byline? A byline is used to let the reader know who wrote the report. It can be a staff, correspondent or any other reporter. The line with this name is called byline because it says by whom the article is written. Write the word by followed by the name. On the next line, write the name of the city or institution. A lead paragraph. A lead paragraph usually answers the WH questions. Who, what, where, when and why. It gives the name or names of persons or things this news is about. It tells us the place where this incident happened. The day, date and time of the day when it happened. The details of the incident. Reasons why the incident happened. In the second paragraph, the eyewitness account can be written to add authenticity to the news. Also, this may interest the reader. Some quotes from the eyewitnesses' comments can be included. can also write what they felt about the incident. Conclusion. It should be concluded with relevant comments. For example, the show was well organized, or the event was successful, or the situation is under control now. Action taken can be described. The future course of action being planned can be described. Can give some concluding remarks. Children, here is a sample report. A newspaper reporter reported on a purse snatching. Kishore, a 19-year-old mechanic, snatches a bag with ₹60,000 from a senior citizen, diverting his attention. The passers-by chased the youth and caught him. Here is a newspaper report. Citizens help police nab purse snatcher. This is the headline. Special correspondent HT. This is the byline. Now in the lead paragraph. New Delhi, 5th October. Alert passers-by on Monday chased and caught a young man who snatched a bag containing ₹60,000 from a senior citizen, diverting his attention. In the second paragraph, the police said that around 11 a.m., Rama Rao, a senior citizen, withdrew ₹60,000 from HDFC Bank. As he left the bank, a youth came up and told Mr. Rama Rao that he dropped some papers. As he looked down, the youth snatched the bag and ran away. When Mr. Rama Rao raised an alarm, passers-by chased and caught the youth and handed him over to the police. Now, in the conclusion paragraph, the suspect was identified as Kishore, a 19-year-old mechanic from Bihar. The police congratulated the citizens for their quick action. Children, hope you understood how to write a report. Now, we shall see an example. We have a question here. Write a report on annual day celebrations in your school. In the headline, you have to write annual day celebrations. In the byline, by, since it is a board exam, you are not supposed to write your name. You can write by X, Y, Z. Now, coming to the lead paragraph. In the lead paragraph, you have to start with the place and the date. Subhash Nagar, March 8. ZBHS Subhash Nagar celebrated its annual day on March 8. A grand stage had been set up with a professional sound system. Our DO madam, Mrs. Vijay Kumari, graced the occasion with her presence as the chief guest. The event began with the lighting of the lamp. This is the lead paragraph. Coming to the second paragraph, our headmistress read the annual report of the school. The glorious achievements of the school were highlighted by her. Prizes were given away to toppers in academics as well as co-curricular activities. The talented students presented mesmerizing cultural events such as dances, plays, magic shows, mimicry, gymnastics, etc. The chief guest, Mrs. Vijay Kumari Madam, addressed the gathering. She praised the school not only for improving infrastructure but also for raising the educational standards. Now we have the conclusion. At the end, the head girl thanked the chief guest, dignitaries and parents for having spared their time to attend the function. She also thanked students, teachers and the principal for organizing the function successfully. The event ended with a national anthem. Hope you understood, children, how to write a report. Thank you.